offensively, make sure that we don't let any of those guys get comfortable, and then just pushing the pace.
Did it feel like a 22-point quarter while it was happening?
No, I was just being aggressive. Like I said, I got some shots to fall in that second quarter. And so those same shots that I had in the second quarter, I just shot them in the third quarter as well.
At what point in your career, or whenever it was, that you became a guy who would not be bothered by an 0-for-7 start or whatever else, and be able to still do what you do?
I think, these last few years is probably where I've been most comfortable, in the sense of, I've always worked hard, I've always put the time in, but just the trust and, having the guys around me and the coaching staff and things like that to, encourage me to go out there and not worry about anything, but being me is probably the most confidence that I've had since I've been here.
James, looking back, what does it like being something more than a half century, 50 points?
It's pretty cool, man, just to be able to, put up half of 50 points in one quarter. I think it's only been done once before that. That just shows, how fast we can get rolling. We haven't particularly been shooting the basketball well this entire series, but yesterday was a good game for us.
You're 3-1, but Trevor keeps saying y'all haven't done anything.
Haven't. We have a long way to go. We're not trying to win one or two games, tomorrow we have to finish this.
You feel like the lid came off in the third quarter because you said you were shooting.
Yeah, for sure. And then from not only myself and Chris, but Tuck hit a three, Gordon hit some threes, Clint got some layups. Just everybody was involved. And that's what we need.
You know what y'all did offensively. What was the thing on defense that ignited all that?
Being active, helping each other out, limiting the one shot, contesting everything. Just having each other's back, we were flying around. That kind of mojo that we had in the third quarter was something that we needed to do in the beginning of the game.
James, coming out of halftime, you and Mike threw up the plays that kind of got you guys going and that work. What's it like for you and him are synced up, and it's been this way for a couple of years, but where he's got that recognition, you can play off that, you like what's called, and it builds and builds and leads.
Well, he knows me now, so he knows this entire team. He knows what the guys need to get going in order for us to be successful. And so I think Chris helps a lot with that as well. That communication between us three, whether it's Chris need to get going or myself, or we need to get somebody else going. So we've had that communication all year long, and so last night was no different.
So that attitude you're describing went up 3-1. Does it help that a couple of you have been in a fairly recent series where a team turned it around from down 3-1?
Yeah, we were in a series against the Clippers and Chris, so he talks about that. But we know how important tomorrow's game is, obviously, and so we're going to play that.
You said he talked about that?
He mentioned it.
How cool was it to see the fan come from Taiwan? I saw you gave him his shoes at the end. How cool was that?
I mean, I saw him in game three, and I wanted to do something for him, but I just couldn't think and lost, and my mom was just racing. And he came back with the same sign in game four, so I was just like, okay, let me take care of business and I'll make sure that trip was worth it, And so just, I can appreciate things like that. Fans coming from, all the way from Taiwan. Just to watch me play in Minnesota, that's a pretty cool feeling for Minnesota.
Thank you.